it's Lynn from WisconsinGarden.net, and today we're going to get a little bit more creative with the zucchini candy that we made a couple weeks ago. That batch was made with Kool-Aid and lots of sugar, and this time we thought, well, what's a more natural, possibly better for you kind of solution we could cook the zucchini in once you have it all peeled and chopped up? So my first thought was to use a natural fresh squeezed orange juice. I need 4 cups of it. And then I got to thinking, well, is that going to be a strong enough flavor? Because originally I was putting in 2 packages of Kool-Aid and 2 packages of sugar to 4 cups of water. So that's quite a condensed solution that I'm cooking this in. Well, so as we were thinking about it, we thought, well, we could cook down the orange juice a little bit more so it is more condensed, then taste it and see if it needed any sugar to go in it, just to give it enough sweetness to be in contrast and give flavor to the zucchini. So I think that's where we're going to start with first. We're going to try cooking this whole container, which is a half gallon, not quite a half a gallon, of orange juice. And I'm going to cook it down until there's 4 cups of condensed juice with it. Now, my husband, being the brains of this operation, decided we perhaps needed an adult candy. Adults like candy just as well as children. So once my first batch is done, to my orange juice that I've used, I am going to be a little more creative. And I decided, well, we both decided, we could add any one or variety of an alcoholic flavoring. We could try the vodka strawberry or the old-fashioned mix. Mogan David, very sweet wine, could add that in. Raspberry flavored brandy. Or you could go with just a natural vanilla, imitation banana, almond. They have all sorts of extracts, even healthy ones that come. And you could always take a little field trip over to Penzi Spices, which is just a little bit away, and see what delicious extracts they might have. But this would give an adult version of a candy. And I'm thinking that if you had your 4 cups of orange juice and added a cup of the liquor or liqueur that would go along for flavoring, that might be very tasty. So we're just going to do some experimenting today and let you know. Oh, zucchini, you have no idea what's coming up for you. So right now I'm just going to shake up the juice and I'm going to start boiling it down. And this should take, probably half an hour, maybe a little bit more. And I know I'm probably cooking all the goodness right out of it, but it's candy after all. Okay, now, we got a little carried away with ourselves, I think, and decided, why not marinate the zucchini before you actually cook it? So we opened up this Bacardi Silver Strawberry, which is a malt beverage. It smells really tasty. And we decided that we would marinate our pieces in here while the orange juice is condensing. Then we decided we might as well do a little experimentation here. And this is a margarita flavoring mix. This one has no alcohol in it. This one is the Mogan David wine, Concord grape. This is the raspberry flavored brandy. And this is the old fashioned mix. this also has no alcohol in it. I'm thinking as we throw these in, the alcohol burns off. So actually, the alcoholic content of this is probably not going to be all that great. It'll have the flavor, though, which is where after the intense flavor. We'll let you know. You know, it's taken me 43 years to get my husband into the kitchen. And guess who did this? Got these zucchinis ready. Boy, all you have to say is, let's do an experiment, and he's right here. I should have figured that out 43 years ago. Right, honey?
Uh-huh. Yeah. So this is where food comes from.
Indeed. This doesn't appear on your plate.
Oh, I thought it did.
Now, in order for these to dry evenly in the food dryer, they all have to be about the same size. Last time I did 1-inch squares, which worked out fine, but they were a little crowded at first in the food dryer, so I am making them a little bit smaller.
Is that so you eat more?
Could be. And you can cut them into any shape you want. If you want to have worms, then you would just cut strips.
I mean, which gummy worms?
Fine. Mm-hmm. Okay. Our orange juice has been cooking now for about half an hour, and it has reduced itself in volume, but upon tasting it, I realized that it's definitely going to be too sour for the contrast of the lemonade I'm going to roll it in afterwards. So I am breaking down and putting in 1 cup of sugar, and I'm just going to stir that so it all gets mixed in, and then in goes the zucchini bits. Now, we've been creative. We use the regular little chunks, but my husband, the creative one, has also made some gummy worm shapes. So these will be long and skinny. Which do you want to do first? Do you have a preference?
No.
Okay. Then I'm going to very carefully dump in. And what I'm after, I think, is just to put in enough so that they are covered. And now I'm going to, once it comes back to a boil, I'm going to simmer them for 30 minutes. So this process could go on for a while, because each batch then has to simmer for 30 minutes before it gets put into the dehydrator. Now, once we have this virgin batch done with no alcohol, then we will use the remaining reduction syrup with our alcohol brew. And again, this was the malt liquor one that had the flavor of the strawberries, which I tasted. And although it did have a little bit of flavor to it, I really wouldn't have been able to get any buzz off of it, I'm sure. The other ones, we were hoping maybe the coloration would come out and change them into different colors, but it really hasn't done that. Maybe a little with the darker, but once we get it into the orange juice solution, it's probably not going to matter. But these will be our last batch so that we don't have all of them alcoholic. We do have 2 grandchildren that like to eat these, so we're going to play it safe. We'll let you know, but then we have adults who might like it. We'll give it a try. Okay, here we go, adults. We did two batches of natural ones for the kids. Now we're going to do the ones for the adults. These have been sitting in here, marinating now for about 2 hours. We've got that whole brew of the malt liquor, strawberry flavored. We're going to toss that in. And my husband, the adventurer, says put it all in. So we're going to put all these different ones together. Now I was thinking, as I was working on these, you could also make a batch with a little kick. If you liked hot pepper, hot sauce, you could put some habaneros in here or some jalapenos that have the hot flavor, because the sugar and the hot might be very good together. Not for me, but for those people that like that sort of thing. Well, there we go. I feel like a witch making a brew here. Smells interesting. Okay, that has to come to a boil and then simmer for 30 minutes. Simmer away. Well, our zucchini adult candy is about ready. It's been 24 hours. They've been dehydrating. And earlier I was able to take the non-adult candy, and that was finished faster because I had it in the dehydrator that had it fanned, so that went faster. Very tasty. I like the country time that we used on it. You wouldn't have to have the on the go, but this was the kind I bought, so this is what I used. But it's very good. Very good contrast between the sugary and the sour. So now, as you take the zucchini out, we'll do this one first. I can turn this one off. As you take it out and you feel it, make sure it's dry, you just toss it in the bag with your lemonade mix. And you want to do this while it's warm. It sticks better.
Now, you could also create your own concoction of what you would like to have as a little extra surface flavor.
And you don't have to use any at all if you don't want to. Mm-hmm. But lemonade, to me, adds a nice contrast. Now, these, there might be some here that, I don't know, that aren't quite done. Okay, so let's say you have them all off. You just put it in a bag and just shake them. And they each get a little coating. Not much. Then take them out. Shake them off a little bit and put them in your jar. Now, I've had Rick taste these to see if he could tell a difference between the non-alcoholic and the alcoholic ones. As you remember, we tried different varieties and using malt liquor and wine and a bunch of things. What do you think?
Well, not really. I mean, it's very good. Even hot off the dehydrator.
Without the sugar on it?
Yeah. Without the lemonade on it.
I couldn't really tell a difference either. There doesn't really seem to be a lingering
I would think it pretty well boils out all the alcohol to begin with. But
Right. Yeah,
it does leave an interesting flavor. Mm-hmm. Not overly noticeable, but, you know, still very, very tasty.
And you could always tell.
I want to try one of those.
Tell your guests that you're serving them an alcoholic vegetable and see if they can figure it out.
I do like the lemonade on there.
Mm-hmm.
That really gives
it's
it
very
a,
tasty. Yep.
A nice little tang, extra tang texture.
Mm-hmm. And then put them in a jar. Keep them tightly closed. Label them, and you probably want to hide them because they will disappear. I've after having experimented with our adult version of the zucchini vegetable candy and noticing that there really wasn't much difference in the adult version as opposed to the regular version, it tasted about the same. We decided that maybe an alternative to marinating it before we boiled it is to just boil it in the orange juice, which was had a very good flavor to it. And then when it's done cooking, immediately scoop it out and put it into a bath of your alcoholic preference, either a liqueur or the malt liquor or the wine. Let it sit in there for a few minutes, then put it in your food dryer and continue drying it until it's done, and then rolling it in the instant country time lemonade mix. So I guess we're back to the drawing board again, back to another experiment. Let us know if you try something and it turns out well, or if you try that version, let us know. We'd be happy to hear from you. Bye for now. Gotta get back to work.